You have entered the Chronix rabbit hole, and we have a YouTube membership rabbit hole request from our good friend Wes Dio. Thank you so much. The song is Insanity's Crescendo, Where Death is Most Alive. The band is Dark Tranquility.
Thank you so much, Wes. We look forward to hearing this new band on the channel.
Thank you. Nice.
That was awesome.
Nell from Theater and Tragedy, everybody.
Thank you very much.
I didn't catch where she was from. Let us know in the comments.
I thought the song was over. Go ahead, pick my headphones up.
Wes, thank you so much for your first request. It's always cool to see what the first request is because it dives into your mind a little bit and sees what gets your juices mm-hmm. flowing, because the first request is always that one that's like, oh, let's get them going with this one. And I think it's a really cool contrast song with the two singers, because it starts mm-hmm. with just the drummer hitting that right at the beginning when she's singing, and that tempo switches mm-hmm. when the male singer comes in, and it actually kept switching tempos when it went back and forth between the singers. And then at the very end, she finally was harmonizing with him at the end. And then it was kind of just an explosion yeah. at the end, which was just amazing. And this is totally up my alley, because a lot of the picking style is like my style of music that I love mm-hmm. because it's very dreamy. Like, it gets you in that state. It's very flowy. And man, it was just so up my alley. And I'm very excited to see what your other requests are, if this was your first one, because it's a band I've never heard about, and I love getting new bands that I get to dive into, and this is one I will for sure.
This was fantastic. Something that I love that I just wanted to play off of what you had said about how they had that duet.
Yeah.
And how they were, the tempo was shifting
yeah.
between the two of them as they were going. It was felt very much like a dance. I couldn't quite pick out the lyrics, but...
Well, it's Insanity's crescendo, so there must have been something yeah. with that push and pull again.
So it was that push and pull between the two of them. There was very often when he was... when he was doing his scream, his growl, he was saying the name of the song, Crescendities and Shendo.
Yeah,
all the time. Insanity's Crescendo over and over again.
Yeah.
But like that duet, that and with that final harmonizing, it brought everything together, because it mm-hmm. was like they layered the two parts on top of each other.
Yeah.
Which is something that I really love, is instead of just doing like a melody, is playing the two parts separately until you play them directly on top of each other.
Yeah.
And because that just adds so much depth to the music for me.
Yeah.
Because I love picking those little parts out when I'm...
And this is 13 years ago.
Yeah.
So like that's, they're ahead of its time, I think. Mm-hmm. And I don't know where this band's from or anything like that, or where they're influenced, or what that you would really call this band. Maybe it's progressive metal in a way, or...
I'm really curious about the female vocalist.
I
did want to hear more of her, I'll be honest.
Yeah, I wanted to hear more of her, too.
I wanted to hear a lot more of her.
Looks like she was a feature.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say, is it looks like she was a featured singer in this band, and that I believe the male vocalist is the main singer of the band.
Possibly.
He introduced her with the exit.
Yeah,
Mentioning exactly. where she was from.
Yeah.
So if you could let me know more about the female vocalist, I would love to know more, know what band she's from and kind of where she comes into the mix.
Totally. She could belt.
She could. She yeah. was amazing.
Yeah.
And he has a very unique growl.
He did.
It had like more of it, because it had a bit of a different pitch to it than what I'm used to
yeah.
hearing, with a lot of growls being a lot deeper. And it played really well with the tone of this music
yeah.
specifically, which is where it is a little bit harder for me to place, because it's like a mix between progressive metal and almost like almost like an alternative.
Yeah, very alternative.
Right. And so
because it had a very like dreamy like, but then it had the like a chuggy like riffs with yeah. it a lot too that kind of kept you moving. But then it was almost like going forward yet to the side, because it's almost like a lull, but they kept you moving really nice.
Yeah, they kept you moving. This is something that I could actually listen to like on repeat.
Absolutely.
Because it has so many different variables going to it while still being easily digestible. So yeah. that was something that I really liked about it. Love both the singers.
7.5 minute song flew by too, right?
Yeah, I didn't realize that was 7.5 minutes. Yeah. Not gonna lie, because it just flew by.
Yeah, we were reacting to some songs that were like 3 minutes or under, and this one almost felt just as long or as short.
Yeah. Right, because when you get into it and they have that ability to keep you moving but kind of all over the place and keep you looking for that next little section. We love that
change of tempo.
And it just keeps you like wanting more, keeps you hungry. Yeah. And so like this band, like it keeps you hungry for them. So like that's something, I love this. Thank you so much for this request.
Yeah, thanks, Wes. You are our first rabbit hole on the YouTube membership. So we really appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
And if you guys also like this as well, then definitely like the video and subscribe to help us out. And we are exiting out of the rabbit hole now, folks. You guys have a great day. Peace and love, y'all.
Peace and love. Bye for now, everyone.
God bless.
Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more Enter the Chronicness.
A special thanks goes out to all of our wonderful patrons. We appreciate you so much.